Welcome back to the workshop. The next build up on the table and full review is going to be AMT's 3-in-1 customizing boat kit. In this kit, you've got enough parts to assemble one entire boat and two entire decks. You can either assemble the runabout, the customized speedboat runabout, or the seagoing dragster. It's got the parts in there to build whatever you so choose. And if you build it the right way, you can go between the seagoing dragster or the thing. You can swap the decks out. They do include enough parts to do that. Now, I'm going to be building the inboard runabout, so I'm only going to be able to do that option because of the way that the seats go in. But it's going to be cool, so let's take a look at everything that's inside the box when you get yours. First up will be the nice manual. It's got this very cool vintage style drawings and everything inside, depending on how you want to do. The windshield, the inboard, the customized speedboat, the dragster, gives you steps depending on which one you want to do. On the back, gives you all your parts lists and tells you how to build the trailer. Yes, this kit comes with a trailer to put your boat on, which makes perfect sense instead of just a boat stand. I like that. The decal sheet included is massive. Now, I'm going to be doing the inboard boat, so the only one I'm really going to be using is the Cutlass for the back, for the name of it. But the rest are for the dragster and the customized speedboat. Now, don't throw it away if you build the inboard boat, because these numbers, all these scallops, all these cool custom paint designs will work perfectly on a car or a truck or a different style boat as well. So you get spares there. Next up will be the clear windshield, which is the same for every kit, and the metal axle, which is for the trailer. I left those in because I didn't want to scratch them. We get two nice trailer tires right there. They are called competition fronts because you want those nice skinny Pro Track tires on a trailer. Smooth wall. Up next will be the interior and the hull. You can see it's a common hull, and you can tell based on the scale it's going to work well with your vehicle. And includes a hitch with that trailer. You can see under the hull is nice and smooth. And inside the hull has got locating marks for the inboard engine or the dragster motor. They both go in the exact same spot on this hull. Then we've got our two interiors, which I'm going to be using both of, because I'm going to be doing the inboard boat. We've got the one way front seat and the one back seat. Those look nice on there. Those just locate underneath the decks. Speaking of the decks, we'll get those out. Those are on two separate trees. We've got the dragster deck, which is all smooth and ready to accept your super high gloss paint job. Then we've got our access hatches, which would be wood for the inboard boat. We've got our dashboard for the dragster, because you really just need a steering wheel and some gauges. We've got wheel covers for the trailer. We've got our trailer hitch for your car. We've got our steering wheel, which is the same on both. And we've got the V8 for the dragster on this tree. You can see underneath, they've got the locating pins nice and proud for your different interiors that you can put on there. And the ejector pin marks are underneath the hull and don't show on the top. So you don't have any sanding to do, because no one's going to be ripping the hull off your boat. You can see that nice wood grain there. That's going to be the inboard runabout hull that I'm going to be using. We've got the fins for the optional customized speedboat. We've got the gorgeous engine, the stock engine for the runabout. We've got the dash for the runabout. And then we've got the rear hatch that goes over. If you didn't want to put the interior on the back, you just wanted it to be a two-seater, they do include that hatch. Next up will be the chrome tree. We've got our baby moons for our trailer wheels. We've got our valve covers. We've got vents, rudder, scoops for the customized. We've got our gauge cluster right here, which means you just put a little wash of black in there and a white highlighting pencil. We'll bring those right out. We've got louvers. We've got the top of that drag motor. We've got other smaller vents and details like flag masts, all that kind of stuff. Now, last up will be the trailer. It's got its own separate parts tree. Nice looking vintage style trailer. We've got some steel wheels, which if you don't want to use those steelies, you can just cover those up with those baby moons and the wheel backs, which will have that metal axle on it. Sits nice and straight. No issues with that. No warpage, no problems. That's going to look nice underneath there. I'll have to think of a color for that. So I'm going to get to working. This is the hull I'm going to be doing. The runabout on top. I like that all sleek wood look like of a Chris Craft. So I got to wash my parts and then I'm going to start assembly and I'll be back. Getting everything ready is pretty simple on if you're going to do the inboard, the inboard runabout. What I did was I assembled the Chris-Craft engine, which is really nice. Now, what I discovered when doing some test fitting is, of course, you want to be able to pop these access panels to show off the little bit of engine in there. I'm going to paint it that Chris-Craft blue aquamarine and give it a black wash. That's all it'll need to stand out a little bit underneath the body. But with the body here, the fuse of the hull, they have you place the engine right on those four pegs so that it leans backwards and give you the idea of a drive shaft going under the water. Now, none of this is going to be able to be seen. Almost none of the interior of the hull is going to be able to be seen. I'm going to paint from about here to here, the inside of the hull, just a darker color, just to give it that, you don't see white plastic when you pop those hatches open. And if there's any holes through the interior that you might be able to see through by accident, you won't be able to see anything bright underneath it. What I did notice was on these pins here, they have a little extra plastic sticking off of each one. What they want you to do is set the motor mounts of the plastic right on top like that. Except when you did that, the hull then sat a little proud. It was a little pushed up in the middle, and we don't want that at all. Let me show you in the instructions. They've got these little extra pins of plastic that the motor sits on. Now, I'm not super detailing it, so what I did was to alleviate that was super simple. It's a tiny alteration to the part, and it takes 2 seconds to do, and it affects nothing bad. All I did was cut those little nibs off, so I had the larger plastic stumps there. The motor still sits in there beautifully. You can see it still has the correct angle. It still looks right. It's still utilizing the motor mounts that stick out from the plastic. There's no problem. But then when you place the body on the top of the hull on, it actually has a chance to push down. You can hear that clicking. That means there's space in between the two. So now it's not going to push up the doors. It's not going to be in the way. And when you open the doors, it's not going to be right shoving up against the bottom of the top of the hull, which it wouldn't do in real life. So I'll be able to paint this clean inside the hull there, paint it up real quick, glue that in place, and the interior will be done. Then I can start working on the top of the hull, which will be the most difficult part, getting the wood grain done. I frog taped, just a name brand of a smooth tape, frog taped those hatches on to make sure that they sit level. So when I paint, I can paint everything even and get an even wood grain. And then I'm going to try a new technique. We're going to talk about it later, about getting those that white combing in between the boards there. So I'm going to give it a shot, see if it works, but I'm going to get to start painting. I've got to paint the interior. I'm going to go online, see what some of the interiors look like on the Chris-Crafts, see what some of the wood trim look like and whatnot, and then I'll get back to working. Once I get the interior painted, I can then paint the dash, put those gauges in, and glue that into place. That just fits right across like that. And then I'll be painting up the steering wheel, getting the steering wheel in. Shouldn't take too long. I'll be right back. More work on the hull. Of course, that's going to be the fanciest part of the boat, so you want that to look the nicest and take your time. The engine is done. It's been washed and stuck in the bottom of the hull. Now, this is just a quick coat of paint. It's going to get scraped as I mount the hull onto different holding tools to paint it and clear coat it. But that's just a basic brown inside there, because when the top of the hull is on, you're not really going to see much. You're going to have the interior here. These two tiny doors are the only things that are going to open. You're not going to see anything but that neat-looking motor with a nice wash on it to bring out the detail. That's the only interior work you have to worry about. Now, the bottom hull is a flat plastic. What I did was, there's no wood graining, there's no nothing. I sprayed it with a dark brown primer. Then I painted it with a milk chocolate, but I did it with a very stiff brush, so it gave me a lot of grain and different texture. Now, it doesn't really show up on camera, but what I did was, as the paint was drying, I took one of these ball tools that they use for nails. You can see the paint on there where it's scraped. They have all different sizes. You can get these anywhere online for a dollar for 10 of them, all different sizes. And I scraped back and forth to give me more of a wood grain detail. I did it along the back. I did it along the side. You can see more up towards the bow where you did that, some of that detail. And that'll give me a little more of a wood grain, but I just wanted to do it as more of a more solid style wood. The Chris-Crafts that I looked up online Some of them had more of a solid style hull, more of a painted, but you could still tell it was wood. That's what I wanted. Then I did the bottom in some reddish anti-fouling style paint. If you're real steady with your hand, you don't need to mask that off. This has all been brush painted except for the primer coat. Now the top coat, the top deck here, was done in two colors. It was done in milk chocolate and a honey brown. And I'm starting to work on that. Now I had an idea earlier to take a scribing tool and scratch out each line to give it that white combing, but I didn't like that. It just didn't turn out bright enough white for me. So what I'm going to do is just give this all a dark wash after I clear coat it. And I noticed that some of the Chris Crafts don't have that white combing. It was an owner's choice if they wanted it. I like the more natural, darker looking wood anyways. So I'm going to leave those seams in there a darker color, but I'm going to bring them out with a wash. I'm also going to paint the very edge of the hull the same milk chocolate, the same teak look. So we'll just get that nice thin line of honey brown on the outside. I kind of did it the reverse. Some other people like it lighter and then darker for the accents. I went darker and then lighter for the exterior accents. So I'm going to finish painting the outer edge of the hull, which is very well defined by the mold lines. And then I'm going to seal that with a clear. I'm going to flip this over and clip it into my car stand and seal that with a nice clear. And while those are sitting over there drying patiently, I'll work on the interior. I'll be back. Motor boating right along on the 3-in-1 customizing boat by AMT. I've got the interiors done. They're not installed in the hull. The hull's been clear coated. It's been allowed to dry for a while. You can see that the nice gloss is developing on there and it's getting all kinds of shiny. But I just placed the interior. I went with a Tuscan red and a black stripe theme on those seats. Did the same with the steering wheel. Got the dashboard in there with the gauges on there. And we can lift that out. It's just loosely attached. You can see how nice those gauges come out. You just wash some black in there, then rub your finger across, and that chrome trim ring stays in place real nice. So I've got the interior tubs done. We're letting the gloss coat finish to dry on the wood hull. While all that's drying, while I've got the other bottom hull over on the paint area drying, all I've really got to do is the trailer. I'm going to give that a coat of gray primer. Then I'm going to silver it up so it looks like one of those galvanized trailers. Not a super silver, but just kind of a basic silver. I want it to look like one of those galvanized trailers you can buy now when you restore your Chris Craft, your inboard boat. You can get a nice galvanized trailer so the trailer never rusts. I'm not going to do a fancy paint job or anything on it. I think those look real nice, those galvanized wheels and trailers. So we'll get that all handled, taken care of. Then what I'll do is I will start final assembly, putting the chrome pieces on, and then finally the decal nameplate on the back once we're all done, because you can't name it till it's done. So I will continue working. When I'm done with the trailer and I'm ready to start putting everything together, we'll take one last look before the final. See you soon. Final assembly can begin on the 3-in-1. I've got to scuff up the tires, just on the tread there, of course. The trailer is done. That came out real nice with a semi-metallic, like a gunmetal, over a black primer. And then I laid strips of non-slip grip tape on the fenders like they'd have to push it in the water. That is just made from electrical tape that I cut to the right size and placed it over the fenders so that you can walk down your trailer and step on the fender and slide your boat in, and you can step on the fender and get in the boat when it's on shore. The interior is glued in. Everything's nice and shiny. If you open up those hatches, you can see the engine that's right there. The engine is done. It's glued in the hull. All I have to do now is join the two hulls. I have to finish assembling the trailer, which is just scuffing the tires, putting the wheels on their axles, gluing them together and sliding them in, and the trailer's done. And then once the hulls are joined, I'll go in using super glue, CA glue, and attach all the cool chrome bits. I'm going to leave the wheels the same gunmetal, bright galvanized metal color so that they look like they should be on that trailer. I'll be attaching the rudder, the propeller shaft, the flagstaff, and some of the vents on top of the boat. And then the last thing will be the decal. I'll be back when the boat's all done. Here we go. It's coming around. The boat is done. It's been named the Cutlass. The decal went on really nice. Everything on this model went together really well. I enjoyed it. There wasn't any fit issues, and I just love that. I love not having to bust out a whole bunch of sandpaper. There was just cleaning up some of the parts that you take off the trees, and that was it. The chrome looks nice. Normally I dull down chrome on a model because I don't like it so bright, but this is a boat and boats like bright chrome. You can see the trailer turned out well. Now I didn't feel like making a special wash for the wheels, so what I did was I just took some of my Tamiya fine panel liner in black and I highlighted those wheels for myself just because I was just doing a tiny amount and nothing else. The hull turned out real nice. I love the way that it worked out. We'll turn it off here for a second. The windshield went on nice. There is no mounting location, so be careful when you put it on. I like to use, on clear glass parts, laser bond. It's that stuff you see on TV with the UV light. It works perfect every time. It never clouds. It never mars the surface. It goes on very easily, and I found it at the dollar store. So take a look at your dollar store. I bought a whole bunch of these, so I'll never have to run out again, and I'll never have to ruin a clear part. I did take a silver paint pen because the windshield has no trim available, and I did highlight that with a silver paint pen top, bottom, and side so that it looked like it had some chrome trim. Otherwise, we got the scoops to bring fresh air in underneath the hull, and then the scoops in the back to pull it out from the engine bay so we don't have any explosions there. I highlighted the handles on the engine bay hatches with a silver paint pen as well because those are molded in. The seats were done in a black and red vinyl look. We got the trim on the front. As you can see on the very front of the hull, if you look right at the bow, it's super shiny. What I did was, I saw in all the pictures when I was looking up paint colors for the Chris-Craft type boats, was that they all had a little chrome strip right on the nose just to protect the wooden boat. When it came into shore on the trailer, it wouldn't ding or rip that up. I have some old silver metallic tape for only 85 cents clearance at the hobby shop. So I just applied a little 1-inch strip right on the front there. We'll get this going again. You saw me paint up all the wood. I think it looks lovely. The hull is done more in a solid wood design. You can see that. We'll stop it right there. It, of course, is shiny, but it's more done in a brushed wood, a solid panel, like they would have decorated it. And then the trailer is done in that gunmetal look, so it really sets it off as if it was a galvanized trailer and a newly remodeled craft. I like the interior. The dash looks great. Overall, it was a real joy to put this thing together. All the underpinnings, we'll pull it off while it's spinning. You can see those went on real well. That's just your prop and your rudder that go on the bottom. The other bump would be for the intake for taking in cooling water for the engine. Overall, great kit. Not expensive at all. There will be a link in the description where you can get yours, like I said before. Right in the description. Always look in there. Other than that, lots of fun. Now, you could go and buy this kit 3 times and build a different boat every single time that really didn't look anything like the one you had just made. That's what makes this one so much fun. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see you at the next review.